When James Venning sits at the harvester controls, there are three screens in front of him, providing information on the header itself, yield statistics, and more recently, protein data.
Just takes measurements every, say, 30 metres and logs a point and logs a measure and gives you a nice pretty map at the end of it to make decisions based on what protein came from where in the paddock and might give you some insight into what's going on in the paddock for the next year.
That approach demonstrates how this South Australian grain and lentil grower views technology. He's all about collecting data that can be used in subsequent years to make the right decisions. Yield maps in particular, he has going on in the background all the time.
I think that where there's really money to be made or productivity to be gained is profiling a yield map versus the season you got. What I mean by that is if you've got a really dry year and you get a yield map, that's a really good yield potential map for another dry year.
The farm is near Bute on the Upper York Peninsula, and James Venning started getting seriously into precision ag in 2015 when he purchased a variable rate air seeder.
Generally, I would say we're gamblers as farmers, like, so you're gambling on the season, and we use PA to help us make the right decision, make the right bet. In January, we're spreading lime to increase the pH of the sandy soils. And then through to seeding, we're verberate seed, especially lentils, and then we're verberate phosphorus fertilisers based on the pH of the soil. So higher pH soil gets more phosphorus, lower pH soil gets less phosphorus.
Getting back to that protein monitor, he says it was a hard one to jump onto because it's not cheap. But he basically uses it so he can accurately blend different protein levels.
So if you've got one paddock that's high protein and one paddock that's low, you can blend to only just meet the grade rather than overperforming, and you don't get paid for overexceeding the grade. So that's probably the decision to try and get in. But in reality speaking, you're probably not going to do a whole lot of that unless it's really obvious. That can really reduce your productivity. But what it does do is it teaches you what your paddock's performing. So yes, you can look at your dockets at the end of the year and you can say, oh, that was the protein out of that paddock, but to spatially see where it's coming from in the paddock and then knowing what you did throughout that year can really give you some insight as to what was the right decision, what wasn't the right decision for the season.
He says the sensor is also detecting moisture. The information has helped dispel a few myths around harvesting late in the day.
When the neighbours are sort of pulling up and stopping, thinking that the moisture's coming up, that the actual measured moisture in the cab hasn't moved yet. So yeah, you probably do gain a little bit of time in the mornings and at the night. Having that peace of mind, you know that it's right. No one ever wants to get a truck turned away from the silos.
Once again, it's an aid in the grain mixing process at that end point.
Get a rain event, you can just come out and know exactly what the moisture is, and if it's a little bit high, you can just make sure that you've got some dry grain to mix with it.
His agronomist has also brought in a machine called a Veris, which tows behind the tractor taking soil samples and measuring pH to produce a map of acidity, alkalinity. As James says, you don't want to be liming soil that is already highly alkaline because it will negatively impact yield. But perhaps more importantly, it tells him where and when to apply phosphorus.
Knowing that the phosphorus ties up on the high pH soils, and that's probably where there's far more money to be made, putting phosphorus in the right places and saving in the other places that are much more efficient using it.
His commitment to precision ag extends to having a weather station on his boundary fence with a moisture probe running into the neighbour's property. They share the data between themselves.
You might argue, well, why would you want to share the data with your neighbour? Well, his crop next door is never the same crop as mine, so it's all about data and the right crop in the right year. So my crop currently is canola, his is wheat, so we can compare notes. If you have a dry year and you remember the year in 2015, it was a dry finish, and but you got this amount of yield, you can go back and look at, oh, well, I had the same crop in that year as this year, and I think we're going to get a bit more rain than that year, so you can sort of predict performance.
For anyone thinking of dipping their toe into precision ag, he says grab as much data as you can. But you can start by using the tech you might already have.
don't need to spend hundreds of thousands on all these whiz-bang tech ideas. Your harvest is probably gathering yield maps, so that's really the basis. If you want to improve performance, you measure performance, you analyze it, and then you learn from it. A lot of people jumping into PA, they'll grab the tech and then they'll look how they can use it. Well, that's probably completely backwards.
He maintains, start with a problem, then work out the appropriate tech solution, not the other way around.
You're making a series of gambles. Some will be right, some will be wrong, but if you've got great data backing you to make those decisions, you're probably going to make the right one more than the wrong one.